tall and I am thin, of an enviable height. And I've been known to be quite handsome from a certain angle in a certain light. Well, I entered into O'Malley's, said O'Malley, I have a thirst. O'Malley, he looked right through me and served some of the fella first. I knocked on the bar and pointed to a bottle on the shelf. Well, O'Malley walked past and scratched his arse, and I twitched and crossed myself. My hand decided that it had enough, and for a moment it slipped from view. When it returned, my hand had learned a brand new trick or two. Thunder from a big black clunk made all the glasses jangle. Oh, when I shot him, I was so handsome. It was the light, man, it was the anger. Neighbors, I cried. Friends, I screamed. I banged my fist upon the bar. I just shot old O'Malley, and my dick fell long and hard. I am the man who waits for no one, and my aim is straight and true. And I'm marked by darkness and by blood, so don't nobody move. Well, you know those fish with the swollen lips that clean the ocean floor? Oh, when I looked at poor O'Malley's wife, that's exactly what I saw. I jammed the barrel under her chin, and her eyes bulged just like those nasty little fish. Her head, it landed in the sink with all the dirty dishes. And her nerdy little daughter, Siobhan, well, we'd all had a bit of fun with. It seemed a bit unfair that she had to be there, so I thought I'd get her over and upon her punching. She stared on in disbelief, looking like the Madonna on the church house wall, painted in whale's blood and banana leaf. Left hook, right hook, left hook, right. She spun round and round. I brought a mighty punch up from the floor, and I lifted her off the ground. Melon, and my fists were gloved in gore, and I shot Counselor Caffrey in the back of the head as he made a run for the every will I sang as I flew about the murder. Mrs. Richard Holmes, she screamed, oh, well, you really should have heard her. I sang and I laughed, I howled and I wept, I panted and I squealed. I blew a hole in Mrs. Richard Holmes, who used her husband as a shield. He screamed, you are an evil man. And I paused a while to wonder, if I have no free will, then how can I be morally culpable? I wonder. I shot Richard Holmes in the stomach. I said it felt good to take your life. I'm not sure, but I think that he thanked me as he lay down next to his wife. It's nice to be nice, I replied to him. He gave a little cough. Yeah, it's nice to be nice, and I neatly aimed and blew his head completely. I've lived in this town for 30 years, and to no one I am a stranger. And I put new bullets in my gun, chamber upon chamber. When I turned my gun on the bird like Mr. Brooks, I thought of St. Francis and his sparrows. And as I shut down the youthful Richardson, it was Sebastian I thought of and his arrows. I said, I want to introduce myself, and I'm glad that you all came. And I leapt up upon the bar, and I shouted out my name. While Jerry bellows, he hugged his stool, closed his eyes and shrugged and laughed. And with an ashtray as big as a really bloody big brick, I split his skull in half. This hurts me more than it hurts you, I said. And I sat on the bar and cried. And for a strange moment, no one moved or spoke. And we all sat like that for a while. It's nice to be nice, I said again. And well, it is, and that's a fact. I smiled at Henry Davenport. I think Henry Davenport smiled back. Well, from the position I was sitting, the strangest thing I ever saw, the bullet entered through the top of Henry's chest and blew his bowels out on the floor. Well, I floated down the counter, showing no remorse. I shot a hole in Kathleen Carpenter, a recently divorced. The remorse I felt, the remorse I had, clung to everything. From the raven's hair upon my head to the feathers on my wings. Life is grand, I shouted, but death is just the best. And I glided through the bodies and killed the fat man, Vincent West. Who sat quietly in his chair, a grown man become a child. And I raised the gun up to his head, an executioner style. Made no attempt to resist, so fat and dull and lazy.
Do you know I live in your street? I cried and he looked at me like I was crazy. Oh, he said I had no idea. He grew as quiet as a mouse. And the roar of the pistol when it went off near blew the roof right off the house. My eye in the mirror and gave it a long and loving inspection. There stands some kind of man, I wrote, and they did in the reflection. My hair combed back like a raven's wing, my muscles hard and tight, and curling from the business end of my gun was a query mark of cordite. Well, I spun to the left and I spun to the right and I spun to the left again. Well, fear me, I fear me, yeah, fear me, no one did, 'cause they were dead. And there came the police sirens wailing, and the bullhorn squelched and blared.
And drop your weapons and come out with your hands in the air.
Well, I checked the chamber of my gun, so one final bullet left, and my hand looked almost human as I raised it to my head. I took one long, hard think about dying and did exactly what they said. There must have been 50 cops out there in a circle around O'Malley's bar. Don't shoot, I cried, I'm a man unarmed. So they put me in the sped me away from that terrible scene, and I glanced out of the window. So O'Malley's bar saw the cops and the cars, and I started counting on my fingers. Three.
O'Malley's Bar.
O'Malley's Bar.
O'Malley's Bar.
O'Malley's Bar. Bar, oh, O'Malley's Bar, oh.